A journey to the mysterious system that keeps you alive. In this video, we are going to talk about the human system as the complex biological system we all know after the human brain, and yet most people do not know how it works or what it is. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel for future updates. Your system consists of hundreds of small members and two large. It's a special transport network spread all over your body day by day. Makes billions of fresh cells like an army crazy suicide bombers. Your biology protecting you from the billions of microorganisms that want to consume you and from your own perverted. What happens when your body is invaded and your first lines of defenses are engaged in an exceedingly very fight forever and death? Just cut on a grimy twig within the park, how annoying. But inside the wound a horrible catastrophe went on. There are dead cells and blood and dirt everywhere. Even worse, countless bacteria invade the warm caverns between your helpless cells to explore their new home, steal your resources, and poop everywhere. Primary stage of defense kicks in the cells. Immediately, the primary stage of your defense kicks in the cells that survived the impact or are hurt or dying scream in panic, releasing an onslaught of chemical alarm signals that awaken your system. The primary cells to accent are macrophages. If a median cell with the scale of a human, a macrophage would be the scale of a black rhino, a stoic cell in essence. But you'd not want to harass it, bacteria do annoy them. Within seconds, the massive cells attack and start killing them without mercy. They stretch out parts almost like the arms of an octopus and grab the bacteria to swallow them whole and digest them alive. A macrophage can eat 100 bacteria before it's exhausted. But there are too many enemies, therefore the macrophages entail reinforcements in your blood. Many thousands of neutrophils develop their signals, move to the battlefield. Neutrophils are intense suicide warriors that only live to kill. They're so addicted to killing that they kill themselves some days after birth so that they haven't got time to accidentally destroy your body from the inside. As soon as neutrophils arrive, they start vomiting deadly chemicals of bacteria or devour them. Some neutrophils go up to now to push their suicide button and explode, casting wide and toxic nets manufactured from their own DNA full of deadly chemicals that trap and kill bacteria. Sometimes they go to continue fighting. While the battle rages, your blood vessels let fluid stream into the battlefield form of a dam opening up towards a valley. You notice this as inflammation. Your thumb swells up barely and gets red and warm. The fluid brings a silent killer into the battle zone. Plenty of complement proteins, a spread of automated liquid weapon that stuns and kills bacteria by ripping holes into them. We made a full kill the invaders. We're reaching a crossroad now. If things go well, your first line of defense kills the invaders quickly. But sometimes the enemies are too strong and would overwhelm your defenses eventually, which means certain death for you, the human. This might be the hour of the dendritic cell, your immune system's intelligence officer. While your soldiers were bashing in heads, it had been collecting samples by ripping bacteria into tiny parts, covering itself in it, variety of a soldier decorating itself within the guts of a dead enemy. The cell leaves the battlefield and enters the superhighway of your immune army, of your immune system that connects all of your tissues along with your immune headquarters, your lymph nodes interested. But after some hours, something clicks, a helper lymphocyte recognizes the bacteria. The dendritic cell coming from the battlefield is attempting to search out a helper T cell, which can somewhat be a way of all purpose commander cell within your immune army. But not any helper blood corpuscle, one that happens to possess just the proper weapon for the bacteria that infected your wound. So it goes around and rubs itself still covered in bacteria parts against every helper T cell it meets. Most T cells are at me low amount disgusted and not parts. This cell is that the weapon that's needed right now. The dendritic cell is overjoyed and activates the helper leukocyte. Okay, wait, why your system encompasses a cell that comes with a weapon against the precise bacteria that infected you? Well, your system contains a perfect weapon against every possible disease in the universe. You've got billions of unique helper T cells that every have weapons against every possible enemy. After the proper T cell is activated, your second line of defense. Second line of defense awakes and rises, sort of a teenager that must rise on a faculty day very slowly. Your heavy weapons are incredibly effective, but they don't seem to be fast. The activated helper T lymphocyte begins to clone itself over and all over again. One becomes two and two become four until there are thousands of them. Now they split into two groups. The primary group quickly moves to assist out your soldiers at the battlefield. Things have gotten out of hand. A tired macrophage is prepared to grant up after fighting for days. It just wants to head to sleep like many of its buddies have done already. But now the helper T cells arrive. One in every of them involves the tired macrophage and whispers something using special chemical signals in a very heartbeat the demoralized soldier feels fresh again. But there's something else, a hot white anger. The macrophage knows what it needs to do, kill invigorated. It throws itself against the enemies all over again everywhere the battlefield, activating line of defense B. This begins to happen meanwhile the second group of helper T cells was engaged on activating another line of defense B. Cells, your antibody factories. Antibodies are protein super weapons that seem like tiny crabs with two pincers to grab enemies. Either like the helper T cells, there are B cells in your body that are able to make just the correct antibodies for each possible enemy. And therefore the helper T cell is searching for exactly these B cells. After daily or two, the correct B lymphocyte is found and begins to clone itself as soon as enough clones are made. Each B cell begins pumping out up to 2,000 antibodies per second a few weeks after you injured yourself and bacteria invaded your second line of defense. Finally arrives fully force. The small army begins to saturate the battlefield, pinching and stunning desperate bacteria. The antibodies clump them together and make them unable to maneuver or fight while your soldiers massacre the defenseless victims. The tide is popping fast. Because the last enemies are cleaned up, you keeps or death. Soldiers realize they're now not needed and start to kill themselves to save resources. But not all of them, some helper T cells remain and switch into memory cells. They're going to guard the tissue for years, ensuring the identical bacteria will never again gain a position here. Similarly, some B cells will stay alive and keep producing a coffee amount of antibodies, making you immune against this bacteria, maybe for the remainder of your life. Sooner or later, you come to life and spot that the wound has grown over and left nothing but a faint red mark. You were completely unaware of the drama yourselves had to pander to. For you, the entire ordeal was a small annoyance, while for many cells it was a deparate fight for keeps or death journey into the mysterious system. But this is often just the start of the epic story that unfolds inside you each day and is told fully in immune journey into the mysterious system that keeps you alive, written by most significant thing you do not know. Explore how incredibly vast your immune system is and the way it actually works, how it fights enemies from cancer to HIV or just the flu. Find out how you'll be able to boost it and if that's actually a decent idea. But this can be just the start of the epic story that unfolds inside you each day. A journey to the mysterious system that keeps you alive.